Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam and today we will study chest x-ray normal anatomy. Here we have PA views of the chest. The dense structures such as bones appear radiopaque or bright, and the low density structures appear dark or radiolucent. We are starting off by looking at the posterior ribs. At least 9 pairs of ribs must be seen behind the lung fields. This tells us that adequate inspiration was taken. These are the posterior ribs, having somewhat of a horizontal alignment. The anterior ribs appear slanted and they are crossing over with the posterior ribs. Always remember that these slanted appearing ribs will be the anterior ribs on a PA view. The clavicles, also known as collarbones, will be superimposed over the lung apices. The scapulae are seen behind the ribs. They are triangular shaped bones. We can also see the thoracic vertebrae and their parts. Here are all of the 12 thoracic vertebrae. They are barely seen behind the heart. Here we can see the 12th thoracic rib coming off the 12th thoracic vertebra. The spinous process can be seen at the center of the vertebra. It has a vertical orientation. We can also see the transverse process right next to the vertebral body and slightly below the rib. The trachea appears as a radiolucent or dark tube-shaped structure because it contains air. It has bright walls which can be very well distinguished. The right tracheal wall is called the right paratracheal stripe, and the left tracheal wall is the left paratracheal stripe. Both these stripes are radiopaque. The trachea bifurcates into right main bronchus and the left main bronchus. There is a cartilage at this bifurcation junction and it is called the carina. The right main bronchus is shorter, wider, and has a vertical course, and the left main bronchus is longer and has a horizontal course. The aortic knob contains the aortic arch. It can be seen bulging laterally here. This is the aortic knob. The aortic knob further continues as descending aorta. The descending aorta will be seen below the aortic knob at this point right here. This is the descending aorta. Superior vena cava is seen over here, superimposed over the trachea and the bronchus. Here is the left hilum. It contains the left pulmonary artery, the left main bronchus, 2 pulmonary veins, nerves, lymph vessels, and other blood vessels. And the right hilum contains the pulmonary vessels, the right main bronchus, nerves, lymph vessels, and other blood vessels. The left hilum is slightly higher than the right hilum. We move on to heart chambers. Starting with the left atrium, this is the location of the left atrium. It forms a part of the left heart border. Below the left atrium will be the left ventricle. The left heart border is formed by the left atrial appendage and the left ventricle. This little bulging structure is the right atrium. It is very noticeable. The right atrium forms the right heart border. The right ventricle cannot be distinguished and it is not a part of the right heart border on X-ray. This is the location of the inferior vena cava. It is seen at the lower margin of the right heart border. The diaphragm is very easily seen. It is dome-shaped. The right half of the diaphragm is called the right hemidiaphragm and the left half is the left hemidiaphragm. Here are the costophrenic angles. They are formed at this point where the chest wall meets the diaphragm. The gastric bubble can also be seen on a chest X-ray. It is radiolucent due to the presence of gas in the stomach. Here we have the lobes of the lungs. The right lung consists of three lobes, whereas the left lung is divided into two lobes. Majority of the right lung is occupied by the upper and middle lobe, and only a small portion of the lower lobe is seen, the region above the right costophrenic angle on X-ray. Similarly, only a small area above and around the left costophrenic angle is the left lower lobe, and the rest of the lung is the upper lobe. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.